jinx it if he can. Jingle jinx it, then he can. Jingle jinx it, what a man.
I'll jinx it for you.
Oh yeah.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful. Ooh, dollar, dollar. Dilly, dilly me. Welcome to another edition of Jibble Jackson. Ooh, what a busy postbag we got this week. Dilly, dilly me. Now we've got a letter here. I'm going to read it to you right now. It's a letter here from a Master Horace Billingham from Salford. That's only £12 on Intercity Seaver. And it says, dear Master Horace, says, dear Jim, could you please jinx it for me to train with the SAS for a day? Oh, nothing, dearie me, the SAS. Then that's a difficult one, because the SAS are very busy people, what, all sort of training undercover and in secret and everything, and nobody knows who they are, because it's all a secret and everything. But what we did was, the BBC, we phoned up the SAS, and we told them that I got an OBE, and that I trained with the SAS for the marathon, and we said, would you help us out? And they said, with pleasure. So what a nice surprise young Master Horace Billingham got when we brought him down to the studios and we bundled him into the back of an army truck, and we sent him off to take part in an embassy siege. So, roll the film. Oh, dearie me. And we met that, of course, on the best possible tits. Meet young Mr. Horace Billingham, who took part in that stage. Will you welcome Mr. Horace? Oh, here he is. Wow, wow, wow. A thousand welcomes. You brave wee boy, you. Ooh. And your mother. You must be very proud.
Well.
Oh, well, I mean, and you big butch. You kick him in the ghoulies, captain of the SAS. Welcome to the studios.
Thank you very much, Jimmy.
Just sit down there, will you? Sit down there. Oh, isn't this great? Wonderful, wonderful. Dearie me. But tell me something. These all sort of, covered in bandages and everything. Did you enjoy yourself?
Yeah.
Why is he wearing all the bandages?
Well, actually, Mr. Saville, he can't hear you. He's suffering from shock. He fell off the rope and broke his leg, and when they threw the grenades in, he was deafened by the explosion.
How about that? Injured while training with the SAS. You see, just a moment, madam, because the SAS, I've got to talk to the captain here. I mean, nobody knows who he is because he's in disguise, you see. Is that right?
That's right, Jimmy. That's even my own wife doesn't know who I am.
How about that? Even his own wife? Well, how does she know it's you?
It's a secret.
Oh. So shall we just call you Captain X?
Why?
All right, Captain Y, then. How's the matter? We're there to Mrs. Captain Y and all those little white fronts at home there. In the secret address on 14 Jewel Carriageway, in Hereford.
Actually, Mr. Saville, I think there was a misunderstanding because the SASE wanted to train with the Salford Athletic Society. I'm proud of this beautiful tracksuit. Have a look at that.
You mustn't fetch yourself, madam. That tracksuit will come in handy for me for the marathon. Don't fish yourself. I mean, what's the motto of the SAS, then?
Who dares win?
That's right, and on this programme, it's who dares loses. Well, you big butch Captain X, you sir. I wonder, would you like to present young Master Horace Billingham with this sort of fell off the rope, broke his leg, injured in the explosion, Jim will jinx it patch?
Yes, of course, Jimmy. Will you hold me gun for me?
I'll hold your gun for you.
There we go.
Isn't that wonderful, man? I've got a little gun here. I'm always going Jimmy Dixon, 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 Jimm